Hi everyone and welcome to today's video. In this video, I want to talk about the move and jump instructions in Codesys using ladder logic. The first one is the move operator. Open the ladder elements and insert it into our programming environment. I'm going to declare the variables. This operator is used for assigning a variable to another variable of corresponding type. In other words, Codesys copies the value of var1 to var2 using the move operator only if enable input is true. It's important to note that input var1 and output var2 must have the same data type. For example, I want to transfer 20 in my isBit variable and var2 only if I press the enable button. Let's simulate the program. I'm going to write the value 20 to the var1. You can see that enable is false and therefore our value is not copied to var2. I activate the enable. Now 20 is assigned to the var2. Let's try another example to understand this operator better. I want to control the speed of a motor. I have an input value and need speed to be 20 when the input value is 1 and 30 when the input value is 2. Repeat these blocks here for the second speed. Whenever the input value is 1, the output of the first equal operator will be on. So the first move will be activated. And whenever the input value is 2, the second move is enabled. Let's simulate again. Now the speed is 20. I write the value to the input value. You see now the speed is 30. Each time it will be changed when I change the input value. Okay, let's talk about jump instruction. This instruction is used to execute an unconditional jump to a program line that is marked by a jump label. The jump label we can place at the beginning of a program line. On reaching the jump instruction, a return to the program line with the label will take place. For example, we have a push button and two outputs. whenever I press the push button, the outputs will be turned on. But sometimes under some conditions, we don't want the second output to be turned on. Just first output must be on by pressing the push button. Here we can use jump instruction. Where do we want to jump? You see, it's written here, no such label, jump. It means we must specify a network to jump to it. Click on the network and from here click on the insert label. Write exactly the name of the jump label that you have written here. Now, whenever the condition push button is not pressed, if I press the PB1, the outputs 1, 2 and 3 will be turned on. But if I press the condition, the jump instruction will be activated. And the execution of the program will be jumped to the label. This one output 2 will not be turned on because the program in this line is not executed. Let's simulate the program. I turn on only the PB1. You can see all the outputs are turned on. Let's turn off PB1. Now if I switch the condition push button, the jump will be activated. Turn on again PB1. As you see, only outputs 1 and 3 are on and the program on the second line will not be executed. If I turn off the condition, the second line will be again executed and output 2 will be true. This is how the jump instruction works and how you can use it in your program. That's all for this video and I hope it was helpful for you. Thank you for your watching. See you next video.